Hello friends, a very good morning to all of you. So I am your mentor Neha Gupta for current affairs, and this is the series for phase 1 current affairs of RBI, SEBI, NABARD or any kind of banking exam at the level of PO. So let's begin this video. I hope that you enjoy these videos, and guys, if you do enjoy the videos and learn something from the videos, then do share it with your friends and spread the knowledge. Now, the students who are coming for the first time can subscribe and hit this bell notification. Also, guys, you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes as well as resolve the queries of students. So if you have any query related to your career or examination, then do feel free to ask us here on this group. Now we are on our first question, which is, who heads the committee formed by the central government to celebrate Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose 125th birth anniversary in 2022? So guys, in the year 2022, the 125th anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose will be observed, and in order to observe the events or organize the events of this celebration, a committee has been formed by the central government. So who heads this committee? It is the Home Minister of India. So the answer is Amit Shah. So he is heading this committee that has been formed by the central government. Now I have one or two informations related to this celebration. So first information is that the central government is planning to establish a new museum on Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose in West Bengal, basically in Kolkata. So we already have one museum in New Delhi at Red Fort, and the expansion activities of that museum is also being planned. Apart from this, a new museum is also in its planning stage. So there are high chances that it can be announced soon. Now, the second information related to the celebration is that the celebrations or the events to mark the 125th anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose will start from next year onwards. Like the Mujibur Rahman's 100th anniversary has started from 2020 onwards. I hope that you know that his 100th anniversary is in 2021. So the whole year in 2020 to 2021 was observed as the 100th anniversary year of Mujibur Rahman. Similarly, the year from 2021 to 2022 will be observed as the 125th anniversary of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. So these were some of the facts related to this news, and nothing much is there. Okay, so I left a question for you. Here the question is, you have to tell me the birth date of Subhash Chandra Bose. When was he exactly born? So this is your question, and I guess it's a really easy question, so all of you can answer it. So do mention the answers in the comment section below. Now guys, this is an important question, so do listen to me very carefully. With which organization has Central Groundwater Board signed a memorandum of agreement for using advanced heliborne geophysical survey and other scientific studies under the National Aquifer Mapping and Management Program? So first of all, I know that majority of you have not understood what this question is trying to say in the first instance. So don't worry guys, I will be explaining the whole purpose of this memorandum of agreement, but let's first discuss the answer of this question. So with which organization has the central government groundwater board signed this MOA? So it is option B, CSIR's National Geophysical Research Institute, which is in Hyderabad. Now guys, what is the purpose of this MOA? I will be discussing that a little later, but I want to discuss this program first, because when I discuss this program, the things will become more clear for you and you will be able to understand all this thing in easily. So let's first discuss this program. So this National Aquifer Mapping and Management Program basically was initiated and implemented by Central Groundwater Board. This is an organization under the Ministry of Jal Shakti. So this program is implemented by the Central Groundwater Board, and The program aims to map the aquifers. Aquifers refers to underground water. Basically, the groundwater which is there under the ground, which is stored in the rocks inside the ground. So that is called aquifers. And in order to map the aquifers that are there in India, this program was launched, which is being implemented by the Central Groundwater Board, which is an agency under the Ministry of Jal Shakti. Now, basic purpose is clear, that is to assess or map the present aquifers yani groundwater in India, so that their management can become possible. So that is the purpose of this mission, which was launched under this scheme, that is groundwater management and regulation. So this is the overarching scheme of the Ministry of Jal Shakti, under which this program, National Aquifer Mapping and Management Program, was launched during the 12th five-year plan, that is 2017, and now it has been extended to 2020 as well. So I hope that these points are clear to you. Now, this point says that the program is implemented by the Central Groundwater Board. The details are shared with state governments for future actions toward water conservation. Now, guys, I hope that you know that the water is a state subject. Therefore, efforts related to conservation of water are in the ambit of central state governments. Therefore, the Central Groundwater Board shares the information collected under this National Aquifer Mission with the state governments, and through the information collected, the state governments take the action towards conservation of water, underground water. Okay, I hope that this mission, this program is clear to you now. Now, what is being planned under this MOA? So basically, this MOA has been signed by this implementing agency, CGWB, in order to use modern technology to map the aquifers. That is the whole purpose. So this is the name of the modern technology that will be used by the CGWB in order to map the aquifers under the National Aquifers Mapping and Management Program. And for this purpose, and for this mapping purpose, and to use the high-tech technologies, this Central Groundwater Board has partnered with this organization, which is in Hyderabad. So I hope now this question is clear to you, as well as this mission is also clear to you. Now, if you have any kinds of doubt related to it, then you can ask me in the comment section below. Now we are on our third question. Recently, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has received the Legion of Merit Award. It is one of the highest military honors of which country? So let me give you a hint. So it was given by President Donald Trump. So Donald Trump gave this Legion of Merit Award to Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and hence we are at our answer. So it is US. Now why this one of the highest military honor of America has been given to Prime Minister Narendra Modi? For two purposes. First is to promote or improve the bilateral relationship between US and India. And second, to take India to another level in the global scenario. So basically, India's image has been improved as a global power in the international market. So that has been done by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in his two terms, and therefore he has been awarded this award. Now, apart from Narendra Modi, two other people have also been awarded, and these two peoples are the leaders of the Quad countries. So if you know who are the members of Quad countries, then you are at your answer. So Quad grouping has US, India, Japan, and Australia. So US is the giver. India has received this award. Narendra Modi has received this award from India. From Australia, it is Scott Morrison that has got this award. Scott Morrison is the Prime Minister of Australia. And from Japan, Shinzo Abe, who was the former Prime Minister of Japan, has got this award, not the current one. So here my question for you is that who is the new Prime Minister of Japan or the current Prime Minister of Japan? Now, for this question, I have discussed everything. And remember this thing, that this year, this Legion of Merit Award has been given to 3 people. Which of the following is India's first indigenous digital asset management platform launched by Niti Aayog? So, it is really important that, and the importance of it is highlighted by the question itself. That is, it is India's first indigenous platform, as well as it was launched by Niti Aayog. Now, this digital asset management platform is named as DigiBox. What is the purpose of this digital asset management platform? Very easy. The purpose is very easy. That is to provide the individuals or the customers, not customers in general, the public. So in order to provide the public a platform where they can store their digital files, this new platform has been launched by Niti Aayog. Now this is important because it is India's first indigenously developed high-tech platform that is for digital asset storage. So that's all for this question. Now, my question for you is Niti Aayog CEO, because he's the person who launched this platform. So I'm curious to know it from you guys, that who is the CEO of Niti Aayog. So do not forget to mention your answer. Okay, which of the following NBFC has received a $40 million loan from Asian Development Bank to support the livelihoods of microfinance borrowers and MSMEs in India? So we have been given 5 options: ESAF Microfinance and Investment, Fusion Microfinance, PTC India Financial Services Limited, BSS Microfinance, or Northern Arc Capital. So out of these 5 options, the right answer is option E, Northern Arc Capital, that has got this $40 million loan from ADB, and the purpose is to provide loans to microfinance borrowers and MSMEs in order to keep them afloat in the times of COVID-19. Now, this loan is a part of COVID-19 response plan that is provided by Asian Development Bank. So remember this thing and remember the amount that has been given to this company and the purpose: microfinance and MSMEs lending. Okay, so here we are at the question where an international organization is involved. So what are your responsibilities? First is to remember all the static facts related to ADB. So what are the static facts? Establishment year, members, headquarters, and the the chief of this organization. So if you remember all these facts, then do mention it in the comment section below. And if you don't, then do memorize these facts, guys, because ADB has been giving loans to India consecutively for a long period of time. Okay, so therefore ADB is an important organization for India, and a question might come up on it as well. Okay, so it is our last question of the day, so do listen to me very carefully. With which country has India conducted its 6th edition of Samvad conference? So Samvad, what is the meaning of Samvad? Samvad basically is conversation or discussion. So the 6th edition of Samvad conference was recently held between India and Japan. So both these organizations conducted this Samvad, and here Prime Minister Narendra Modi has proposed to establish a library in India that will promote traditional Buddhist literature and scriptures. Now guys, this is just a proposal, nothing concrete has been provided by either of the government, neither Indian or nor Japanese government. So nobody has said that the library is going to be established in India. Rather, it is just a proposal made by Prime Minister Narendra Modi to promote Buddhist culture, Buddhist literature and scriptures. Now, that was a very basic fact. Apart from this, related to the Samvad series, I have one interesting fact. So the Samvad series began in the year 2015. And the first edition of the series was held in Bodh Gaya, Bihar. Now, if you know that Bodh Gaya is one of the very famous Buddhist site in India, can you guys name all the sites that are very famous in relation to Buddhism? If you can, then do mention it in the comment section. And now I would like to take a leave from you. And if you have really enjoyed it, then do subscribe to our channel and come tomorrow for the next lecture. Thank you so much.